Thank the gentleman. Now let me recognize the gentleman from Minnesota, Mr. Hagedorn.
Mr. Chairman, thank you for the opportunity. Ranking Member, Mr. Kelly, it's nice to see you. I see my friend, Mr. Rice, over there as well. I just wanted to briefly come in and talk about a couple of concepts that we're working on for legislation that are going to end up in front of your committee. But first, I'd like to associate my myself with the remarks of Congressman Davis on the USMCA. The trade agreement with the United States, Canada, and Mexico is very, very important for southern Minnesota and Minnesotans in general. And I can tell you that we have dairy farmers that are counting on this. It's really going to expand the industry, going to help us export. In the state of Minnesota, it's not just agriculture. It's mining, it's manufacturing, it's machinery, it's medical. And I'd say the expeditious passage of that bill, when we have an opportunity, is going to be very, very important. It's going to give us the certainty we need. It's going to expand our markets. And more importantly, I believe it's going to establish momentum moving into some of these other agreements. How do we expect the administration and our country to move forward with China, Japan, and others if we can't get this one through? So as somebody who supports USMCA, I just want you to know that from my standpoint here in southern Minnesota, I think it's critically important that we move as expeditiously as possible. The second thing I'd like to address, there are a couple of things, I guess a little bit related to the tax reform bill that was passed here a year or so ago, and the fact that I believe anyway, and I know there may be some disagreement on the other side, but I think that that legislation has had a lot of good impact out there in the economy. The economy is expanding. I talked to all sorts of folks in many, many different industries that will tell you that there have been benefits. There's a lot of jobs created, and the fact of the matter is we're having a tough time right now filling a lot of those jobs. In our district in Minnesota, I recently went to a company called Alumacraft. They make very nice boats that are exceedingly fun to be on in our 10,000 lakes in our state. And their deal, though, is they need machinists. They need people that do welding. They need people from the vocational, you know, the vocational schools, the trades. And when I spoke with not just the, you know, the business leaders, but also the folks in the unions and others, and they'll tell you that there's a little bit of a glitch in the system right now, that some of those monies and those education accounts can't be used for vocational training. So we have a bill that we put together. We'd like you to consider that at the time. Be introduced very soon. I think it should be a bipartisan bill, something that we can at least make sure that everyone who possibly wants to go to vocational school as opposed to a four-year college, and four-year college is great, but it's not for everyone. We'd like to see us move forward together on that. The second would be the concept of this, and I think we can both agree that the previous tax bill was more focused on businesses and corporations, if you will. It was on that side. And the individuals in America still are waiting, many of them, for something. And one of the things that I think we should explore is the idea that no American should have to pay federal taxes on the money that they need for medical care, health insurance, dentistry, whatever, because every American deserves the opportunity to have a flexible spending account. Why is it just people who work for the government or in big companies? Why shouldn't the individual American have a flexible spending account? And I guess I would look at it this way. If you believe healthcare is a right or you don't believe healthcare is a right, either way, what right does the government have to tax you on the money that you need to go procure those services? So as we put that legislation together as well, I know that would be costly and we'd have to find some trade-offs, but that's a concept that I hope the committee will consider, and we'd be happy to work with any of your members in any way possible to see that through. With that, it's a very short statement. I'm going to let you move on to the next group, if that's okay.
I thank the gentleman, and let's assure you that your comments on vocational education are widely shared here.
Thank you. Appreciate that, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. We'll proceed now to the next panel. Please take your seat.